Hello students, today we will be studying about the utility analysis. We have discussed the cardinal concept. Here we will be comparing both cardinal and ordinal. First of all, in cardinal concept, the utility is measured in units as we used to do in the law of diminishing marginal utility as well as in equimarginal utility. We used to measure the utility with the help of units. In ordinal concept, we can't measure the utility in units. So we have to rank it or compare it using another thing with it. Like you have to use another combination in order to tell whether which one is more useful or which one is of high utility to a person. Starting with the chapter, ordinal utility analysis. First of all, who was the person, who was the economist who criticized Marshall? Marshall used to say that the concept is cardinal. We can give some units, we can use some units, imaginary units, to measure utility. But Hicks said it can't be done like that. We have to compare it. We can only compare two things, two combinations, in order to tell which one is better or which will give you more utility. The next is the concept of indifference set. First of all, we will study the set. Set is set 1, set 2 I have taken. First of all, we will be discussing the set 1. In this, we have combinations, different combinations I have taken, A, B, C, D. And there are two goods. One is apple and the other is orange. Number of units you can see, I am taking 1 apple and 20 oranges. This is the combination, you can say. The A is the combination of both, which means 1 plus 20 I am taking. The next is 2. 2 plus 12, 3 plus 8, 4 plus 6. But the consumer here, what is the consumer behavior? Consumer here is equally satisfied with all these combinations. He will be able also, and he will buy A, B, C, D, any combination, but the satisfaction will not be different. There will be no difference in the satisfaction. The next is your combination set with set 2 with E, F, G, H combinations. Here I am taking 2 apples, 20 oranges, 3, 12, 4, 8, 5, 6. All these I am taking. We have to draw some observations with all these combinations and even the sets. First of all, what observations have been collected out from set 1? First of all the combinations are specified according to the consumer's tastes or preferences. He is ready even to take 1 apple and 20 oranges, 2 apples and 12 oranges, 3 apples and 8 oranges, 4 apples and 6 oranges. All are giving him equal satisfaction. There is no discrimination with the satisfaction. Next is each combination has same level of satisfaction, which I have discussed, that the consumer will get equal satisfaction at each and every point because there is no difference among the combinations. As I'm saying that satisfaction at A is also equal to B and also equal to C as well as D. So all these are indifferent to consumer, and all these combinations, consumer is having no difference of satisfaction. That's why these are the indifferent combinations. The consumer satisfaction across all these points or all these combinations is indifferent. So it is called indifference set. Fine. And the third one is all these combinations together form indifference set. I'm not talking about only one combination. I'm talking about all these combinations collected together will form a set. Indifference set. This is one set. This is another set. Obviously, there will be a difference between the satisfaction of this set and this set. Both will be different. Consumer will get less satisfaction here. As you can see here, I'm starting from 1 apple and 20 oranges, total of 21 items. Here I'm starting with 20 oranges and 2 apples, 22. Overall satisfaction is more in this set. So that's why the consumer will prefer this set over this set if both the combinations are possible, only then. Next, I have drawn indifference curve. There is nothing much to tell in this. I have taken apples on x-axis, oranges on y-axis. I have plotted this combination over here. And you will get a graph like this. The graphical representation of the individual, I am talking about the set of the indifference curve. One indifference curve is indifference set is known as indifference curve. The graphical representation of indifference set is known as indifference curve. This is one indifference curve. This is second indifference curve. I have written one similar to set one. I have written two similar to set two. I have drawn both the sets with all the combinations, four combinations of set one, A, B, C, D, and the another set also I have drawn, E, F, G, H, the combinations I have drawn here. Two indifference curves we have here. When we have more than one indifference curve plotted on the same graph, this is one single graph, I have plotted two indifference curves. I can plot 3, 4, 5, as many as I want on the same. Then it is known as indifference map. This whole is indifference map comprising of indifference curves. Two indifference curves are there and we are having the combinations. They will make indifference set. A, B, C, D combination make indifference set. A, B, C, D whole the graph, the curve will make indifference curve. And IC1, IC2 along with these X's will make indifference map. So set 1 is preferred over set 2. I have discussed why it is preferred, because higher indifference curve, as the indifference curve will be upwards, this indifference curve will be giving more satisfaction. Fine. This is a new indifference curve. This is a new set. Whether the consumer will be that set 1 will be of less satisfaction, set 2 will be of more satisfaction, as the combination of goods are giving us a representation, you can say, but they are telling that here the items I am getting is more, here the items I am getting is less, that's why it's giving me more satisfaction, that is higher satisfaction in comparison to this set. I'm not talking how much satisfaction is this one giving me. Okay, we will move towards the definitions of all these I have discussed with you. First of all is indifference set. It is a set of those combinations of two goods. I have discussed that there are two X's, therefore two goods which offer the consumer the same level of satisfaction. The level of satisfaction is same, so that the consumer is indifferent across all the combinations in his indifference set. In one indifference set, consumer is ready to take any combination without any problem. He is not having satisfaction problem. Fine. I have drawn a set over here. You can draw any set. This is 2, 5, 3, 8, 4, 12. Then is your indifference curve. I have drawn indifference curve over here. X axis represents X good, Y axis represents Y good. It is a diagrammatic or graphical representation of an indifference set. This I have told you earlier also, of a consumer. It represents all those combinations of two commodities that give a consumer the same level of satisfaction. Fine. We will be using one equation to represent this indifference curve, that is utility gained. Utility is the function of each combination, you can say, and that combination is giving you the same utility, which is the constant here. If I take A combination, then also I'm equally satisfied, I'm getting the same utility. If I'm taking the second combination, or if I'm taking nth, you can say any of the combination from the indifference set only, it should be from the indifference set or the curve only. Indifference map. What is indifference map? A set of indifference curves drawn in a graph, the graph should be same, is called indifference map. Indifference curve 1, 2 and 3. Higher indifference curve, as we move towards the second or the third, higher will be the satisfaction. This will give me higher satisfaction. This will also give me higher satisfaction. That is, you can say IC3. IC3 is giving me the maximum satisfaction. IC2 is less than that. And IC1 is the minimum among these three. Next is ICs. That is your indifference curves need not be parallel to each other. It is not necessary that they should be equally parallel, like this one. the one I have drawn here. This is going parallel, but after that it is coming closer to the IC one. Fine. So it should not be equally parallel to any indifference curve, you can say. The indifference map, it is not necessary that it should move parallel to each other. Indifference curve never touch or intersect each other. This will also be discussed in the properties of indifference curves. Moving towards the properties of the indifference curves, the very first property is an indifference curve always slopes downwards from left to right. That is from left towards the right. That is, it has a negative slope. We have discussed about the negative slope in the demand graph also. What is the reason behind this? All the combinations give same level of satisfaction we have discussed. Moving from A to D, when I am moving from A towards D, what is happening? You can see the quantity of one good is decreasing. Which one is decreasing? Here the quantity of Y is more. You can see at point A, the quantity of Y, OY, this one is more as compared to X. X is this much only. If I am moving from A to D, the quantity of Y is decreasing. See, this much has been decreased. Only this much I am buying of Y and this much as I am of X, which means that the decrease in the commodity X or the quantity of commodity Y, I'm talking about Y. Y is decreased and it is compensated. How will I compensate the decrease or the loss? That I will compensate by gaining more of the commodity X. That means I'm getting more of X and less of Y at combination D. You can mark this by, numbers also. The quantity can be marked as numbers, so you can mark the quantity and you can rectify it. Next one is your non-satiety, which means that I am preferring. The consumer is rational, as you know. The consumer is preferring the larger basket over the smaller. I want to maximize my utility, so I am maximizing it by taking the larger. I will prefer to buy a larger basket of a thing. Larger here means that it contains more of one good. Either it can be Y or it can be the other one. So the larger quantity or the larger basket means more quantity of one good and at least as many of the other. The other good should be there. It is not that way that the other good should be missing or you are sacrificing the whole good. No, you are not doing that. You are getting both the goods. One is in more quantity, the other one is in less. Either one can be in more or less. Next property is the indifference curves are convex to the origin. I have drawn two shapes. You can see indifference curve is of this shape. This is known as the convex shape. The other shape is the concave shape. Concave, our indifference curve is not this way. The reason behind is indifference curve analysis is based on one assumption, that is diminishing MRS applies to the consumer behavior. Consumer behavior, how it works is, as per the indifference curve, the marginal rate of substitution is diminishing. Fine. We will be studying about diminishing rate. MRS, the marginal rate of substitution of X, fine, for Y is defined as the number of units of commodity Y. As I am taking one or two additional units of X, I have to sacrifice Y. So that must be given up. How much I am losing Y? The loss of Y in exchange for an extra unit of commodity X. I am gaining one or additional unit of X and I am losing Y, which means I am compensating myself by adding the units of X and losing the units of Y. So the marginal rate of substitution is this. The marginal rate of substitution is this and it is diminishing. It is assumed that it is diminishing. This is the reason why the shape is convex, so that the consumer maintains the same level of satisfaction. In order to give the same level of satisfaction to the consumer, he will compensate his loss by gain of the another good. We will be studying this with the help of one table. I have taken the set. Set 1, you can say. I have taken A, B, C, D. I have taken the combinations apple, 1, 20 are the oranges, 2, 3, 4. Combination is 2 plus 12, 3 plus 8, 4 plus 6. Fine. What I have to do is I have to calculate delta y and delta x. How is delta y calculated? You don't have to take this as I'm not having the previous value. So I can't subtract. In this, you can say I have to subtract this. How can I subtract? 12 minus 20 minus 8 divided by 1, as 2 minus 1 is 1. 3 minus 2 is 1. 4 minus 3 is 1. Here is 1. 1 additional unit is being added, so that's why it is being divided by 1. 12 minus 20 is minus 8. I have to lose 8 units and I have gained 1 unit. The next one, I have to lose how many units? This is minus 8 and this is minus 4. And what about this? This is 6 minus 8. That is equal to 2. I have not done anything. Minus 2, sorry. I have not done anything. I have written delta y, which I have calculated this. I have written delta y. That is, delta y over here is minus 8 divided by 1. It is equal to minus 8. Minus 4 divided by 1. It is equal to minus 4. Minus 2 divided by 1. It is equal to minus 2. Here you don't have to consider the point, this one, the negative sign. You just have to see the value, that the value is decreasing, which means the diminishing marginal rate of substitution is there. Another way is using the graph. I have covered both the ways. This is another graph. In this, the concept of one additional unit or more than one will be clear to you. I have taken delta y at point A. I can't calculate as the previous value is unknown. At point B, this is the slope also, so be careful when you are calculating this. Delta y I have calculated by subtracting this. I have subtracted this value. As I am losing this, I have taken negative sign over here and I have written 1.5. Delta y is 1.5 over here and delta x is 1. How I have calculated this? I have calculated this by subtracting 2 from 3. That is 3 minus 2 I have calculated delta x, and this is your delta y. Negative sign is there because I am losing this. I'm ready to lose this part and gain 1 unit. I have to move towards B by doing so. Marginal rate of substitution is 1.5 minus 1.5. Another part I have done. In this you can see I have talked about, or I have taken additional units too. Fine. So that's why I have to be very careful while calculating. I have taken delta y equals to, this is 4.5 and this is 3. The difference is 1.5. Delta x is 2. 5 minus 3. 1.5 divided by 2. Nothing is being done. Just delta y divided by delta x is done to find out the marginal rate of substitution. This is negative 0.75. Next you can see is, this is the delta y 0.5, as the difference is 3 and 2.5 and the calculated value of delta x is 2. 7 minus 5. 7 minus 5. I have taken 2 here and I have calculated the value. Here also the rate is decreasing. Diminishing rate, you can see. Similarly, you calculate the slope of IC, that is your indifference curve. Delta y upon delta x. It is negative because I am losing 1 or 2 or more units of y in order to gain, or compensated by the gain of x, units of x. Next property is indifference curves do not intersect. It is very easy. I have told you that this is the indifference map. How can I say that they do not intersect? if they will intersect, the definitions will be wrong, because indifference curve states that all the combinations give the same level of satisfaction. Fine. And indifference map states the there is a set of indifference curves like this 1, 2, 3. There is a set. If I'm talking about the set, and the set each representing each indifference curve representing different level of satisfaction, the level of satisfaction from IC2 should not be equal to this, should not be equal to this. So very careful. At IC1, you can see what are the points A, B and C. There are 3 points, which means IC1 should give satisfaction, equal satisfaction at A, B and C. Another is IC2. It is with D, B and E. D, B and E. How can it be possible that both are giving B? Which means if B is here, all the points are equal, or the points are giving equal satisfaction. This can't be possible as per the definitions. So this is contradictory. That's why intersecting is not possible in indifference curves, because there can't be any combination in difference curves or different indifference curves. There can't be any combination or point which gives you equal satisfaction. If this point will be giving you equal satisfaction, then all these combinations will be giving you equal satisfaction, which can't be possible. The next point will be covered in the next lecture. If you are having any doubts, let me know in the comment section so that I can cover your doubts also in the next video. Thank you.